Welcome to the very first Why Play, where I'm going to be looking at a game that I really like and trying to convince you that you should be playing it. We're going to be looking at some themes and settings, some cool gameplay mechanics, and some really beautiful components as I really try and hammer home why you should be playing it. But what is this game that we're looking at this time around? Well, I'm going to be telling you why you should play The Bloody Inn. So, what is The Bloody Inn? The Bloody Inn sees players take the role of a family, basically setting up an inn in Ardèche in a remote corner of France, a really secluded area where people really just pass through. So what a better place to put up an inn where people can stay the night and then move on? But you really need to try and get as much money out of them as possible. So what lengths are you going to go to actually get that money? Possibly even murder? Well, you have that option in The Bloody Inn, and it is a game that not only will test your moral compass, but also your greed as you try and take as much of that family fortune for yourself as the game goes on. Although you all own the inn together, you've all got your own selfish desires to make as much money for yourself as possible. So, if you kind of fancy yourselves the next H.H. Holmes, then you should probably get psychological help, but also this game may be right up your street. Now, you can probably already tell that this game's theme is pretty dark, and it's reflected wonderfully in the artwork. The game's cover depicts this almost contorted-faced man with a permanently horrified look, backlit by an ominously red backdrop, and this consistently runs through the entirety of this game's components. The art style is almost a more cartoonish take on Victorian-esque portrait paintings, which in themselves look haunting and really help to set the atmosphere for the game. So what about the game itself? Well, it's a card management game with a Euro feel. Players will attempt to make the most money through various means, but this is a light Euro game, so competition is limited to taking stuff that suits how you want to play before anyone else can. You can mess with people slightly though. At the beginning of each round, you'll populate the rooms of the inn by placing a card in each room. Each player will have a room assigned to them. The first player then chooses which rooms each person stays in, and that will become important later. Players then get two turns per round, one at a time, in clockwise order. So what's the easiest way to make money? By murdering someone and taking all their money. But murder isn't so easy to get away with. For a start, some people might just be too tough for you to take down. Secondly, you're the honourable sort, so you're not going to take a cadaver's money until you've buried it. But where to bury it? And thirdly, if there's a policeman occupying one of the rooms in the hotel, you'll be caught if you can't hide the body by the end of the round. And seeing as you only get two turns per round, it's going to take some proper planning to get things right. You're going to need some accomplices. It's a wonderfully thematic system of goals and targets as you look to create your own gang of evildoers that will help you bribe more people into your gang with their own unique abilities and ranks. You see, the rank of each person represents how difficult they are to bribe, how difficult it is to gain their permanent ability, and even how difficult it is to kill and bury them. To trigger any of those actions, you're going to need to pay for them with as many cards in your hand that meets their rank. The cards you use to pay for each action then go safely on their merry way, unless they're a peasant, in which case they just hang out in your bistro. Rather than bribing one of the travellers, you can instead bribe up to two peasants in one turn from the bistro. Each card may also have a suit that dictates an action that, when taken, will see that card stay in your hand. For example, if they have the cash suit, they can be reused when taking the bribery action, or the trowel suit means that card stays in your hand when used to build an annex, which not only then applies that card's ability to you permanently, but also gives everyone a place to bury bodies. Yes, I said everyone. You see, there are a number of ways of making money without ever killing anyone. You see, every built annex can hold a number of bodies under them equal to their rank. Should someone decide to murder someone and bury them under your annex, you don't get the chance to deny them, but you do split the money gained 50-50. So you can mess with people by burying low money yielding bodies in other players' annexes to fill them up and deny them as many opportunities to get 100% of the profits for themselves. But it also offers owners of high value annexes the opportunity to let other players do the risky stuff, like killing people, while still making money. On top of that, there are some annexes that simply give you money over an ability, and at the end of each round, every room that still contains a traveller gives the owner of that room a 1 franc bonus, meaning you can be strategic over how you place the travellers at the beginning of the round. Putting travellers that are less likely to be used over the round in your own room, while giving the more tempting travellers to the others. But I mentioned earlier that this is a game of hand management. Not only do you want to build a hand of cards to help you obtain your goals, but you also want to keep it efficient. At the end of each round, you need to pay your gang of thieves, which will set you back 1 franc per card in your hand, which will also stop people from playing the game of hoarding all the cards.
So let's review exactly why you would play the Bloody Inn. Well, for a start, it looks great, and the theme fits its systems beautifully. It is a game where you really need to think about card management, of which cards you really need to keep in your hand and which ones you need to get rid of to try to keep your hand light. Now, it is a Euro game, but it is a lighter one, so it's a really good way of being able to dip your toe in the waters of Euro games, which are usually pretty heavy. So, despite its theme, it's actually not a particularly aggressive game, so it's kind of ideal for people that dislike constant player interaction, usually revolving around conquest and things like that, but instead offers kind of a lighter way to interact with other players around the table. And finally, I did want to say that you can genuinely win a game of this without being a complete and utter bastard. See, although it has themes of murder and things like that, if people feel like they aren't really into that kind of thing, they can legitimately still be competitive in this game simply by offering a place for people to bury bodies without actually committing the act themselves, which still is rather morally repugnant. However, it doesn't quite touch those waters, so it really has a good way of getting around things like that. But all in all, those are the main reasons why I really think you should try this game. I've had it for a while and I absolutely love it. In fact, we took it and played it in France when we went there one time. Brilliant game. Really have a great time with it. So with that, I really hope that you've enjoyed this first episode of Why Play? And hopefully a few of you will have watched and are seriously considering giving this a go now. But I tell you what you could do for us if you are one of those people. Give us a like, maybe leave a comment down in the comments down below, and maybe subscribe to the channel. Or perhaps if you've really enjoyed it, we also have a social media account. You can find us on Twitter at EverybodyDice and on Instagram at EverybodyDiceShow. We also have a Facebook page, facebook.com/EverybodyDice. And hey, if you really enjoy what we do and fancy supporting the channel by throwing a couple of bucks our way, then by all means go over to patreon.com/everybodydice, and there you can find a couple of little bonus extras you get for as little as $1 a month. You basically help shape our content through a series of polls and things like that, as well as an audio newsletter, and we're planning a few other things down the line as well. But anyway, please click the thumbs up, and maybe click one of the videos that should be on screen right about now. Thank you very much for joining me on this one. See you later. Bye now.